Hello and welcome. This is my first scene breakdown, requested by Bayo Richard. So this is for you, Bayo. He wanted to know how to do this underwater scene, so I'll do a little breakdown and hopefully give you the info you need. Here's the scene. I acquired these models from Rem Infographica years ago. You can obviously find lots of models nowadays on different sites. So, the texturing on the battleship, this is the Bismarck, is very straightforward. It's just box mapped with noise, texture, very rough to make it look rusty. The seabed has these modifiers on it. A subdivision, which I've hidden in the viewport. Obviously it slows it down. A shrink wrap, this is the main active one. So that's acting positive and negative towards the hull of the ship. So as you can see, it moves up and down where the ship gets close to it within a limit of 0.15 meters. And then there's a smooth, which I've deactivated for speed of the interface. And if I switch that on, it just obviously just gives it a nice smooth appearance. Underwater wise, it's basically just a light. A couple of lights here. If I zoom in on these, you have two lights, a wide and a narrow. So that's your mission. Obviously, the settings on here depend on the size of your scene, the size of the objects. So the important bit is the underwater effect, and that's this shape here with this material. Taking the object's coordinates, and I've put a noise through it to try and vary the depth effect a little bit. It's not very visible, but it's subtly there. Using a color ramp to give it a bit more contrast, that feeds into these two multipliers, which then feed onto absorption and scattering, added together to the volume. Basically, these two values, you control the depth effects, the density of the fogging, which will depend on the size of your scene. So you'll have to play with these numbers for your particular scene. I've also added a small box here which has a particle system on it that gives you a little debris and the little particles, you know, in the water. This is the object I use for the particles in the water, and this is the material for that. Essentially, a bit of noise that goes through a spherical gradient, so it's rendered like a little blob with a foil off. That goes in your alpha, and then a random color. So it's basically choosing a random variation from these colors for each particle. And finally, the compositor settings is what we've got. The denoising, that's an important one. You activate that up here in passes, data, switch on denoising data, and that will give you these outputs. That should actually come from here. It's a question you have to test which one works better. But basically, if you add a denoise and you take the denoising normal, put it in the normal, denoise albedo, put it in the albedo. Now, here's a little step that I've done because the denoise really gets rid of lots of detail. So to bring back a bit of detail, if you mix back some of the original, this is 80% denoised, so 20% the original, it gives you back a little bit of that granularity, a little bit of the natural noise that should be in an image. Obviously you can change that, so got full original or fully mushy bees. A little bit of a grade just to bump up the light and keep the darks down. So you see that. Using M to activate and deactivate. That's a nice way to test. Then we have some glowy stuff, quite subtle. So these are the settings for that. Got streaks. So where it's bright, it gives you a little streak across. And then overall glare. That one doesn't do a whole lot. Add those together. And then lens distortion gives you a little bit of chromatic aberration at the edges. I always like that. Just a little bit, 0.05. And that's it. Well, that pretty much covers everything. If you have any questions, let me know. If you want to see more of these kind of videos, like or comment, and I'll see what I can do. In the meantime, thanks for watching, and enjoy 3D Land. Bye.